गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। गुड
गुड मॉर्निंग सर। गुड
मॉर्निंग।
मॉर्निंग सर। गुड
गुड
मॉर्निंग।
मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग। सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी वेर सीइंग अबाउट स्कूल डेवलपमेंट प्लान। इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द मीनिंग function and constitution of a school development plan. In this class we will discuss on the state policy on school development plan, means what are the policies of Orissa state government for school development plan, that we will see here. Okay, so anybody of you know that what are the state policy or what are the recommendations of government in the Odisha for school development plan? Anybody have idea about that?
Okay. Achha,
anybody of you have seen the RTE Act 2009? Have you seen the RTE Act? नो सर, आरटीई एक्ट भी नहीं देखा?
हाँ सर, देखा है।
देखा है, अच्छा। इज देयर एनी कंपोनेंट देयर? हाँ देखा है। क्या देखे हैं पल्लवी, आप बताइए उसमें क्या है, कुछ एनी इंटरेस्टिंग विच इज रिलेवेंट टू आवर करेंट पॉइंट ऑफ डिस्कशन?
सर उसका सब फीचर्स देखा है, पर ये जो स्कूल डेवलपमेंट प्लान है उसके तहत जो उसका थोड़ा सा ठीक से नहीं पढ़ा है सर।
नहीं पढ़ा? अच्छा ठीक है, नहीं पढ़ा कोई बात नहीं। अच्छा, उसमें एक पॉइंट लिखा हुआ है कि डिफरेंट स्टेट्स, सिंस वी नो दैट द एजुकेशन, हाँ राइट टू एजुकेशन एक्ट 2009 दैट आई एम टॉकिंग, शी इज रिप्लाइंग द मैसेज। सो सिंस एजुकेशन इज अ मैटर ऑफ अ कंकरेंट लिस्ट, कंकरेंट लिस्ट मीन्स बोथ स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड अ सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, विच मीन्स दैट बोथ स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड अ सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट कैन मेक अ अप्रोप्रिएट रूल इन द एजुकेशन। Both state and a central government are free, but at the same time we have a federal structure of Indian government, है ना, संघीय ढांचा जिसमें बोलते हैं, we are federal structure. So some within the education also there are something where the central government can make act that will be applicable throughout the India, but state government are free to notify the rules as per their local demand. Rule, appropriate rule will be made by them, but act will be applicable throughout the India. And in that sense, when we see the RTE Act, so it is applicable throughout the India. Earlier it was not applicable to Jammu and Kashmir because of their special status, and the state government will notify a appropriate rule for implementing RTE Act. So in that way every state has notified a rule under the RTE Act. And in that rule you will find a detailed description that how that will happen, and there this is the point of a discussion about school development plan, SMDC, these all things are discussed, that what it will be, how it will be constituted, how it will be function, and how it will be monitored. So I hope that some of you must have seen that rule or heard of that rule. Have you heard of that rule? Yes or no? अच्छा नहीं देखे हो तो just now I am showing, it will be made available in the learning platform also. Learning platform, I have very sorry to say that I have visualized, I have invested a lot of a thing, money, power, manpower also, but due to the disturbance in my life, I could not able to do. But slowly now I am starting. I have streamlined the mathematics pedagogy course. In that, already in the advance, all the materials are I'm making available. Within this week, management will be streamlined, and then I will think about the MED. Okay, so this I am having the target. So 1-2 weeks it will take to streamline. So mathematics pedagogy student may be able to understand that I have streamlined, all the materials are available there in advance, but this will be also there, so don't worry about that, it will be for you also. So are you able to see the screen? I think now you must be able to see. Is the screen is visible to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. This is the document. The Orissa right of children to free and compulsory education rule. See, that was the act. And this is the not the act. This is the rule made out of the act notified by the central government. And that's why it is saying, the conferred by the section 38 of right to children to free and compulsory education act 2009, the state government do hereby make a following rules to implement that act, because that act promises something. So in order to transact those promises, there is a rule is required. So every state, they have notified a rule, and this Orissa government has notified a rule in 2010 September. Okay, so they have notified, and in that you will find different things are there, but we will see the relevant part. Whole document I will be sending to you, so don't worry, you can see the other part also if you are interested, and you must see also. My request will be, you must see. Okay, so just very briefly, we will see the school management committee, and then we will go to the school development committee. So this rule says that every school will have a school management committee. In every school, a school management committee will be constituted. Okay, and there is some relaxation that those who are unaided. Okay, and the member of the school management committee will be 12 to 16, and the jurisdictions of it will be within that school only. Means you cannot go beyond your school. Okay, and the school management committee will be reconstituted at an interval of every 3 years. And there is a parameter that how it will be constituted. I mean, who will be the member? Out of 12 to 16 member, who will be the member? And what will be their percentage representation? So this document says that the 75% will be the representation of a parents or a guardian of a children, those who are studying there. So 75% representation will be there. The remaining 25%, within the 25%, 1/3 will be the elected member of a local authority. So many time I have talked to, like a PRI member, like a Jila Parishad member, sometime MLA also, they are there in some school like that. 1/3 again it will be amongst the school teachers. Okay, like a representative of a school teacher, representative of the school staff, teaching and non-teaching staffs, एंड द अगेन 1/3 विल बी द लोकल एजुकेशनिस्ट अवेलेबल देयर और द स्टूडेंट रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स और द अलमनाई रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स. सो 75% इज अ पेरेंट्स और अ गार्डियन एंड आउट ऑफ द 25% दैट इज अ रिमेनिंग 1/3 इज द इलेक्टेड मेंबर, 1/3 इज द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ अ टीचर एंड अ स्टाफ, 1/3 इज अ रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ अ स्टूडेंट, अलमनाई और अ लोकल एजुकेशनिस्ट. दिस विल बी द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ अ स्कूल मैनेजमेंट कमिटी एंड ऑब्वियसली द कमिटी मेंबर दे विल एलेक्ट वन चेयरपर्सन एंड अ वाइस चेयरपर्सन. They will elect, means again there will be election within the committee member, that is the 12 to 16 committee member, and the head teacher of that school will be the senior or the senior most teacher of the school will be the member convener of the school management committee. Like that it will be notified, the decision, whatever the decision they will be taking, that will be notified in the public place, like that the throughout the school in the notice board. That is the very common thing. Their function will be to communicate the work is going on within the school and the other things to the government, to the local authority, to the parent, to the guardian, like that. That is also the responsibility of this to implement the clause A and E of the section 24 and 28 of the Act, that is the RTE Act, that is the insurance of 25% of children from the weaker section should come, free education should be there, like that the sections are there, in that in those section it has been talked. Okay. It is also responsibility of the committee is that teachers are not burdened with non-academic duties other than those who are specified in 27 of the Act. 27 of the Act says that the work related to the emergency, urgency and election kind of a work, because our country is a democratic work country, and a democratic country like India sustains over the election. So election is the one of the important part in the democratic country, so it cannot be denied. So that in that non-academic work they can be involved, or there is a something urgency, emergency, like that in this pandemic it is a kind of a national emergency. Okay, so in that way they can be used in the non-academic work also. Then they are also supposed to work for the ensure the enrollment and the retention, that is a continued attendance. They have to also maintain the norms and the standard that is referred in the Act. Okay, they have to prepare and monitor the plan for implementation of a different work. They have to also monitor and implement the midday meal. They have to also prepare and maintenance the annual account of receipt and expenditure of a school, that how much expenditure and receipts are coming. So these are the some of the work of the school management committee, or it is also have a responsibility of maintaining the accounts. And that account will be signed by the chairperson or a vice chairperson and the convener of the management committee. Convener means a principal. Usually the headmaster or a senior most teacher, that will be convener. And the chairperson and the vice chairperson are the elected member out of the members of a school. So this is the work of the school management and development committee. Now come to the स्कूल डेवलपमेंट प्लान दैट हियर द स्टूडेंट स्कूल्स आर ऑल्सो रिक्वायर्ड टू प्रिपेयर अ स्कूल डेवलपमेंट प्लान मीन्स अ प्लान फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ द स्कूल दैट इन द कमिंग टाइम वॉट आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स दे हैव एंड इन ऑर्डर टू फुलफिल द एम्स एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव दैट दे हैव फ्रेम्ड आउट वट काइंड ऑफ अ वर्क दे विल बी डूइंग एंड हाउ इट विल बी ट्रांजैक्टिंग मीन्स अ डिटेल्ड वर्क प्लान इन ऑर्डर टू अचीव अ सर्टेन थिंग रिलेटेड टू द वर्क ऑफ अ स्कूल एंड दिस सॉरी दिस डॉक्यूमेंट सेज दैट द एवरी ईयर स्कूल डेवलपमेंट प्लान विल बी मेड इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट यू विल प्रिपेयर अ स्कूल डेवलपमेंट प्लान वेल इन एडवांस फॉर नेक्स्ट 10 ईयर्स और 5 ईयर्स यू मे हैव अ एम एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव फॉर नेक्स्ट 5 ईयर्स और अ 10 ईयर दैट विद इन द नेक्स्ट 5 ईयर आई वॉन्ट टू डेवलप दीज थिंग्स और आई वॉन्ट टू मेक अ प्रोविजन ऑफ दीज थिंग इन द स्कूल You may have a objective or a aim for that, but the specific plan will be prepared every year, and it also says that before the end of the financial year, each year. So financial year is ending in a March. So it will be prepared by the end of a December every year. For the next year plan. Why it says that? Because in order to implement those plan, it is required so many things. Some of the time the finance may be required, some of the time the manpower may be required, some of the time the expertise may be required, some of the time it may be required to consult the experts. So many things may be required. Suppose that you want to make a provision of a good computer laboratory. So in order to have a computer laboratory, you need first the thing is the finance. Second thing is the technical advice that which kind of a configuration will be appropriate enough, which model of a computer should be installed. What are the different requirement for running a computer lab like internet connectivity, electricity connectivity? If it is there, then applying and getting the connectivity. If it is not there, then thinking of the alternate way. So it will take time and it requires to manage all the things, require times to manage all those things. So that's why it says that 3 months before the starting of a financial year you must complete it so that when the financial year will start it will start in April you will prepare in December so 3 months it will take to for the financial approval because for the finance if you required then you have to send the concerned department and you have to get the fund it will take time Suppose that you need advice, expert advice over that. So you will send it to the concerned department or a committee or a concerned person for the advice. It will take time. So the point of saying is that when it will be prepared well in advance by the end of December, so the school will have a time. To implement that and to work on that. So that's why they are talking about the 3 months before it must be prepared. Then it says that the school development plan that will be prepared must be comprised of 3 annual sub-plan. 3 annual sub-plan means व्हाटएवर द थिंग्स यू आर प्लानिंग दैट शुड बी जस्टिफाइड. यू कैन नॉट से दैट आई नीड अ वेरी बिग कंप्यूटर लाइब्रेरी, वेरी बिग लैबोरेटरी एंड लाइब्रेरी और प्ले ग्राउंड, प्रोविजन ऑफ फैसिलिटीज लाइक दैट, बिकॉज ऑल दोज थिंग विल बी डायरेक्टली प्रपोर्शनल टू द स्टूडेंट स्ट्रेंथ यू हैव. हाउ मच स्टूडेंट स्ट्रेंथ यू हैव. So that's why this document talks that you have to give a data that what are the student strength, what was the student strength in the previous 3 years, so that you can estimate that what will be the student strength in the coming time, in the next year. Suppose that for sake of example, when we talk about our department UDT, we have 48 in the B.Ed and 37 in the M.Ed. So next year, suppose that this year we have announced the admission. So this year, suppose that we will get some student. Again in the next year, we will get some student. So based on the data that we will be having, we can estimate that how much student will be enrolled and based on that also we can estimate that out of those student what are the different things is required to be planned in the department, like that the sitting arrangement in the class also. How much sitting arrangement should be there, because for that we require an infrastructure. For the sitting arrangement in the library also, for the sitting arrangement in the laboratory also, recreational areas also, assembly area even also, the number of teacher, the number of classes, all those things. So that's why it talks that before developing a school development plan, there must be some data available for the 3 annual years, previous 3 years. And that's why the three kinds of a data they are suggesting. The first data they are suggesting is that a class wise enrollment for each year. What is the enrollment in the past 3 year, year wise, in each classes, in the class 5, 6, 7, like that, so that you can easily point out, so that you can easily configure that how much the facilities are required. Suppose that we have a science laboratory in secondary classes 9 and 10. So we must know that how much student we have, so that accordingly the work space in a laboratory will be arranged. Suppose that we are making a provision of enhancing the library. So if we will have a class wise data of a student, then we will be able to understand that how much textbook from which class, which genre, which area is required. Suppose that for a lower class student, the flavor of a text should be picture in a story format, in an interesting format. So the how much book are required for them, how much book is required for the secondary school student. So that you will be able to estimate. And why? Because it requires a huge money for that. We cannot bring a huge amount and let it unspent. Suppose that aapne 10 crore rupees le liya, but you are not able to spend because you may not be capable enough. You may not be you may not have a sufficient resource for utilizing, और यू मे नॉट हैव अ नेसेसिटी इवन समटाइम, है ना. सो बट अदर स्कूल मे बी रिक्वायरिंग द मनी एंड वॉट विल हैपन, यू हैव टेकन अ 10 करोड़ ऑफ रुपीज, सो अदर स्कूल आर सफरिंग. सो मे बी द केस. सो दैट्स वाई दे यूज टू टॉक दैट वॉट आर द रिक्वायरमेंट, वॉट आर द एनरोलमेंट ऑफ अ स्टूडेंट क्लास वाइज इन ईच ईयर. And then next they talk about that the requirement of number of additional teacher, including head teacher, subject teacher and a part-time teacher separately for a classes 1 to 5 and 6 to 8 calculated with the norms of a specific norms specified in the schedule, that is the schedule of a Right to Education Act 2009. Because manpower in a school is a one of the important factor, and that is also an important factor for utilizing the funds that you are getting, because you require so much of a thing also, you need so much of a thing, you got the money for those things also, but if you don't have a manpower, then you won't be able to utilize all those resources. So that is the point. So that's why they used to ask talk that the school development plan that you are preparing, that also must be comprised that what is the strength of a teacher there and a staff there, and how much a staff is required there, including if it is required to keep a guest teacher or a contractual teacher, that should be also indicated clearly, or a part-time teacher, or a specific teacher from the specific subject, like that. And it also cover the physical requirement of the school, like additional infrastructure, additional equipments like a bench, desk, chair, facilities in the classroom, school and other places, like the for the reading room, the reading table and chair, book display, almira, like that. It may be like that the some other facilities like a public addressing system, okay, like that. It should also cover, and the requirement will be as per the norms, means you will see the availability of an infrastructure per student, like that if you have a 30 student, then you require a one class, but if you have a 60 class, then two classes are required. So accordingly the infrastructure will increase. So like that, it is the main purpose of saying is that. Then the additional financial requirement in respect of clause B and C. B and C we had, a B is a requirement of a teacher, that is the human resource, and the C is the recruitment of a requirement of a additional infrastructure and equipment, that is the physical resource. So the point of saying is that what is the finance required for the deploying human resources and deploying the physical resources. So these things needs to be seen, that needs to be mentioned in the school development plan. And since we know that when the school development plan we are talking, so before preparing the school development plan, the school management committee, that is the highest authority in the school for management of a school, is there. एंड वी नो दैट द कन्वेनर विल बी द आइदर अ हेड मास्टर और अ सीनियर मोस्ट टीचर ऑफ दैट स्कूल एंड द चेयरमैन एंड अ वाइस चेयरमैन विल बी इलेक्टेड बाई द मेंबर्स ऑफ द स्कूल मैनेजमेंट कमिटी. सो एक्चुअली दे आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर डूइंग ऑल दिस एक्सरसाइज बिकॉज फॉर प्रिपेयरिंग अ स्कूल डेवलपमेंट प्लान स्कूल मैनेजमेंट एंड डेवलपमेंट कमिटी इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल. So they will prepare or some other can assist in preparing that, but it will be endorsed by the chairman or a vice chairperson and a convener. Convener is the headmaster or a senior most teacher of the school to whom they will appoint, and then it will go for the local authority before the end of financial year in which it is prepared. Local authority means the district education officer, block education officer, and they will forward to the government, or they may disburse the fund available to them. So for dispersal of a fund it will go to the local authority. So that was the all about the state policy about the school development plan. State policy, this is the policy of a government of Orisha. Okay, so this is the state policy. So now we have a 10 minute and we will have a question answer session during that 10 minute. So any question and a query, if you have, you can raise here. Yes, please.
Yes, sir. No question, sir.
Yes, sir. No question. Okay, so we have a 10 minute only. So within the 10 minute, starting a new topic won't be very fruitful. Okay, or let me. Achha, there is some question from the Biswaranjan. I will take care. So I will respond the Biswaranjan's query and then I will stop the class here, because within the 10 minutes it won't be possible to start the new things. Biswaranjan is saying, sir, is there any single state policy for Orissa? Single state policy means what,
sir? मैं पूछना चाह रहा था कि सिर्फ क्या यही एक स्टेट पॉलिसी है जो ओडिशा के लिए काम कर रहा है, क्या इसके अलावा भी कोई है?
ना 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 ना, देयर आर लॉट ऑफ पॉलिसी, ठीक है, एंड लॉट ऑफ एक्ट, लॉट ऑफ रूल्स रिलेटेड टू द डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ वर्क, डिफरेंट सेक्टर्स, डिफरेंट थिंग्स. दिस इज द पॉलिसी आई एम टॉकिंग रिलेटेड टू द स्कूल डेवलपमेंट, एंड फॉर द स्कूल डेवलपमेंट दिस इज द वन पॉलिसी, बट फॉर द अदर थिंग ओरिसा गवर्नमेंट हैव अ लॉट ऑफ पॉलिसी.
ओके सर.
Okay. So this is how it will be single, because lot of things are there in a different sector, no? Like a company, like a higher education, like a technical education, so many things are there. So for the different thing, different policies are there. Okay. So Salvi is one is Rosaline is asking, school improvement plan and school development plan. Yes, it is the same as I have told earlier also in the previous classes. Yes, it is the same, very much same. We are stopping this class here. Thank you for being with me in this class. Have a nice day.
Thank you.